there, me again. If you don't know me by now, if you don't know me by now. Yeah, it's me again, Terry Kay, Beer Goggles, Reviews and all that. I get fed up with kind of introducing myself the same way, innit? The only difference I can make with myself is whether I have the beard and all that, whether I don't. And if I shave this off, like, I look like a round head, like Mr. Potato Head. So it's kind of a little bit of King, who was it, King Edward, was it? Well, I look like a King Edward, look like a spud, a potato. Get on with it. I'm sorry, folks, I've gone off. Off I go. Let's go. We've got Jennings. Quick note on these. Jennings, Witchwood, are owned by Marsden's, I believe. And Witchwood, some of their beers have gone a bit downhill. Just of late. Now, this same thing happened before with Wells and Young's taking over. Well, Wells and Young's. Wells taking over Young's, or Young's taking over Wells. Wells taking over Young's, I think it was. Pardon me. And that was good, wasn't it? And then taking over Courage and God knows what else. And completely ruining all sorts of good beers. Now, Witchwood, a really good brewery. I say really good brewery, really good for... They have been really good for the real ale and kind of craft beer and whatever else you want to call it, but proper beer world. Getting kids away from... kids and young fellas and girls and that, away from the Popsi McLagers out there and away from the indoctrination corporation beers and things like that. All the corporate crap, you know, the mass debated, mass indoctrinated stuff. And that was great. You know, the people would see the lovely little artistic labels and would kind of, why am I sitting so low? And would be, I've got to try that one now. That looks cool. Of late, they've been a little bit, I tried Hobgoblin recently and it was, tasted more like Goblin than Hobgoblin. And it used to be a really fine beer. So, I'm hoping that the same isn't going on with these, because Jennings have been some fine beers. This one's award-winning, it says. Well, I think most breweries are. Of some sort of award or another. But, I've had some fine Jennings beers before. I think, can't remember, Snecklifter I think was one. As the crown, very pretty, very nice. It's not smelling bad. It's smelling quite good. I'll put my crown up here, over there like that, because I've got to jam it back on. Save a bit for later, you know. Right, it's poured out. I don't think we're talking bottle condition. We're talking 3.5 ABV. But I'm going to pour that out. Now when you're pouring, pour it gentle to start with, whatever you're pouring. Pour it right down the edge of the glass to start with, and then you've got a little bit of gut, you know, decision later on how much head you want. If I'm not pouring it for camera, I'll pour no head, you know. But there you go, that's just me. So you can pour it, just lift it a little bit and pour your head in. There is the little pretty thingy there, the old colour of head and everything. Making nice lace up the glass there, and there is. So with this one, on the dark ones, look at the glass. Look at the paper, I mean, over here. That's the colour that I'm getting through, that there. Right, dead on it, yeah. Sniff. A slight putty edge to it. I think I got this off of one of theirs before. It may be something, maybe one of the sulfites or something like that. Kind of one of these sulfite tablets or something. Or I think, as it happens, they'll have the Burton Snatch there. I think they're brewed on there nowadays. So there's a slight, not skunky, but that kind of slight putty edge with kind of almost a slight egg background. But not an off, it's not just a tinge of something on the nose. And that's kind of those sulfites there, it's burnization. Yeah, you're getting not a lot past that. You're getting slight, very slight biscuity edges there. You're getting a bit of digestive biscuit, the digestive dippy in your tea. You're getting a little bit of a dark kind of fruit. A little bit of something like a blackcurrant, a little edge of that. Right, and there's not much else going on. Cheers. No, I'm not impressed with that. It's very plain. A slight oiliness in the mouth, but it's very plain. It's got kind of that, like an East Kent Goldings and a slight Fuggles going on somewhere around that area, but it needs something to perk that a little bit. It's kind of a bit drab and a bit kind of wet raincoat, you know. No, I don't like that one. I don't like that. Jennings, bitter. Don't know what it's like on cask or anything like that. I'd imagine it would be much better. But that as it is, don't bother. There's a lot of cheaper beers that you can get in cans and whatever else. That, don't bother. Enough said. Cheers, see you in the next one.